Hello guys, in this video or presentation we're gonna see some risk idioms, the main idioms you need to know that talk about risk. Let's get started. Now the first thing we should do is define risk. Risk means the possibility of something bad happening. It can be a feeling, you know, you feel that something bad will happen to you if you do something. That is risk. Okay, so let's start with this one. Our first idiom is nothing ventured, nothing gained. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. What do you mean by this idiom? It means you can't get things done if you fear risk. For you to get good things, you need to risk. Otherwise, if you fear risk, there's nothing you can do. Okay? Don't forget that. Let's see an example. You need to invest money to make money. You need to invest money to make money. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. That's a good idiom you can use to talk about risk. Let's move on to the next one. Our next idiom, or idiom at number two, is sail close to the wind. To sail close to the wind means do something that is risky or dangerous. To do something that is risky or dangerous. Don't forget that. To do something that is risky or dangerous. Let's go on the next one. Or let's see an example. If you keep sailing close to the wind, your boss might fire you. If you keep sailing close to the wind, your boss might fire you. Okay, so don't sail close to the wind. As you know, this idiom comes from sailors or the guys at the sea. When you sail close to the wind, your sail might break and you may lose your boat. Okay, don't forget this very good idiom to talk about risk. Let's continue. Our idiom at number three is put your neck on the line. What do they mean by putting your neck on the line? You know, you all have a neck, you know, that thing below the head, or that connection between the head and the body, it's called the neck. So if you put your neck on the line, they mean to do something dangerous or something that you could suffer the consequences. You do something dangerous or something that you could suffer, you know, after. There are some effects after that. So we say to put your neck on the line. Let's see an example. Our example is, I put my neck on the line for them because of love. I put my neck on the line for them because of love. Probably your family, your friends, your students, your loved ones. Every day we put our neck on the line for people we love. We put our neck on the line for things we love to do. We risk our lives. Okay, this is a good idiom you can use to talk about such situations. I put my neck on the line for you. She put her neck on the line. Don't forget that. Let's continue. This one looks like the previous one at number three. But to put your head on the block. You put your head on the block. What does it mean? To do something dangerous or something that you could suffer. These are almost the same. It's all about risking your life to put your head on the block. Let's continue with an example. I put my head on the block for you so that you keep your job. Here you can protect your co-worker or your classmate by using this idiom to show them that you risked your life, or you risked your position, or you risked your, So this is a very good idiom you can use to talk about risk. I put my head on the block for you so that you keep your job. I put my head on the block. I put my head on the block. I put my head on the block. And don't forget that. Let's continue at 5. At 5 we have go for broke. Go for broke. What does it mean? Go for broke. Now, go for broke means to risk everything in the hope of having great success. To risk everything in the hope of having great success. You got that? People go for, people do a lot, in the name of success. We risk every day. Let's see an example. Many people go for broke to make it to Europe or the US. You've seen many people trying to get to Europe. They want to make ends meet. They're looking for greener pastures. They want to try out the other side. They want to, to succeed. They want to help their families. Or they are escaping from war. They are escaping from problems back home. So you can use this idiom to talk about such situations, to talk about such life experiences. Many people go for broke. Many people go for broke to make it to Europe. You know, they risk everything. They sell everything. They risk their lives crossing the Mediterranean. They risk their lives, doing whatever they can so that they can get to the other side, so that they can find a better life. So people go for broke. Some people even sell their property, they sell their houses, they sell their homes, they sell their everything to go for broke. They go for broke. Okay, that's a good idiom. Don't forget it. Let's continue. At 6, to be skating on thin ice. To be skating on thin ice. What does it mean? It means to do something that is very dangerous. Do something that is very dangerous. Be skating on thin ice. Yeah, this is a good one. Let's see an example. The police did skate on thin ice when they moved in. The police did skate on thin ice when they moved in. Here, the police really risked their team by attacking the gang, by attacking the robbers, by attacking the criminals, because it was really risky. Maybe these guys had powerful guns, or these guys had better weapons, or it was a bomb squad. So people, these men and women of the police forces, really risk their lives every day. So you can say, you can use this idiom to talk about risk, to skate on thin ice, to skate on thin ice. You've seen people skating on lakes that have ice on top. Yeah, that's called thin ice. Anytime the ice can break and you can drown in the lake or river or sea. So skating on thin ice, it's very risky. Those who have skated on thin ice, you know what I'm talking about. I haven't done so, but I couldn't. I fear risk sometimes. Okay, good. Let's continue. At 7, bet the farm. What does betting the farm mean? It means risking everything you got. You risk everything you got. It means bet the farm. You can bet the farm for anything. You can bet your farm for everything. What is a farm? You all know, chicken, cows, cattle, horses, sheep, yeah, those animals are on the farm. Imagine risking all your farm for something you need, for something you love. So this idiom is really good. You can bet your farm, you know, for love. You can bet your farm to help your family make. You can bet your farm to help your business. You know, betting isn't the best thing you do. Oh, it's not the best thing you can do. So risk is betting the farm. Let's see an example. She bet the farm by investing all her money in the company. She bet the farm by investing all her money in the company. You see, this lady, or this woman, or this girl, or this princess, bet all her money. Imagine your mom, imagine your sister, investing all her savings, all her hard-earned money, just for better life. You put in your money in something, you know, believing that one day your money will come back, believing that one day you'll have return on investment. But in the end, you lose everything. So you can use this idiom to talk about that. She bet the farm by investing all her money in the company. Let's see our last idiom. A leap in the dark. I love this one. A leap in the dark. To do something without being certain what will happen in the end. To do something without being certain what will happen in the end. Yeah, this is a leap in the dark. You know, you jump. Got to jump in the dark because you don't know where you're gonna fall, or you don't know where you will fall. That is a leap in the dark. It's also a risk idiom, and this is our last idiom. But before we conclude, let's see the example. For example, there's this manager of a team. Let's say you're a supporter of the best team in the world, and your manager is not playing the striker you really need to see on the pitch. That guy you need to see playing is seated at the bench. So what you say? That the manager is leaping in the dark. The manager leaped in the dark, or the coach leaped in the dark by not playing the striker, by not playing our best player. The coach leaped in the dark by not playing our best guy. The coach is leaping in the dark, is risking everything. Okay, so let me hope this presentation helped you to learn some 8 idioms you can use to talk about risk, you can use to advise someone about risk. So let's go talk about risk, and thank you for watching this. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, just hit that subscription button and hit the like button, the thumbs up, and share this video with your friends who fear risk and those friends who don't fear risk. This is Ronnie, your teacher. Come back and see and learn and enjoy English. Take care and stay blessed.